just see the trailer.
Yeah.
Which is pretty incredible.
It looks dope, right?
The next season, yeah. So how epic is it going to be compared to season two?
I think it's definitely it's a bigger world. You know, season one, it was very contained on the ship, kind of all in our character's point of view, not really knowing what was going on in the outside world. Season two opened up a bit more with what's going on in America, and now we're going even wider with more scope. You know, we're going all over the world. We're splitting the storylines to a degree where some of it is on the ship, and then some of it is back home in St. Louis with the president, what's going on with decision-making at home and the political intrigue at home, how to hold the country together while also trying to expand their aspirations to help save the world and to protect the world and to not just get the cure out there, but try to hold countries and regions together because in the wake of the apocalypse, you know, the infrastructures have fallen. So we're in a much bigger scope, you know, in a variety of different countries in Asia. You know, I think the show continues to expand both in theme and in scope.
Does that mean that the characters won't get to interact as much? I mean, they're going to be separate storylines?
Absolutely.
It's kind of sad.
Yeah, it is a little sad. When I saw Marissa today, who plays Kara Foster, we saw each other, was like, hey, you know, we forget we're on the same show now. But I think it's really great of reading what I've read and imagining the different worlds. I think the whole White House storyline, which Kara is now a part of, brings just yet another dynamic to the show. Something that I think moving forward is needed, you know, and it feels good. I think it's great like this. I think people are going to be invested in the different aspects and different storylines. And we do split up, and of course there'll be times where we come back together and be reunited, and it's all the better.
Can you tease at all what your character is going to be doing this coming?
Sure. Well,
without giving spoilers.
Absolutely. Well, for me, Lieutenant Burk, I have a brother, Cameron Burk, who's my older brother, who survived on his own during the apocalypse, and now he's back on the ship. He's a lieutenant as well. He's a new TAO. And we kind of bump heads a little bit initially. We have that brotherly conflict that we had growing up. And as Stephen Kane mentioned, that, you know, when we were growing up, we did the little fights about things that brothers would fight about, and now we're bickering, and there's a lot more at stake here on the ship. So that's a lot of fun. He's played by LaMonica Garrett, and he's great, a great guy, great actor, and a great addition to the cast. And along with him, we have some other new faces this year, as usual, and they're just all fantastic.
It's a fun expansion. You know, the world that our world and scope expands, and also the characters are expanding in that they're in different roles, different dynamics. He has a brother, young Miller, who's joining the show this year as a series regular, who was, you know, mentored by Lieutenant Burk in the beginning of season one, is now coming into his own. And you meet his mother in St. Louis, and she has a key moment, a key role. You meet Sasha Cooper, who is military liaison and diplomat in Asia, and it turns out she has a past with Chandler. You see Kara in a different role than what she's used to. You see Chandler as the chief of naval operations, which is not what, you know, the new job for him, and Slattery's now the captain. Garnett, who used to be the third in command, is now the XO on the ship. So that's what's fun about the evolution of the show, is putting the characters in different situations, and it keeps the show feeling fresh and like it's evolving. So
this is a series that has production and set like none of them. Can you talk about what that's like working in that kind of set?
I still get lost when I go into our set of the Nathan James. Like, there's so many hallways. We call them P-ways, but yeah. There's so many P-ways and rooms and.
I still do too.
I still get lost.
It's embarrassing. Like one of our PAs on the set, Trini, you know, I'll come after shooting a scene and I'm just lost as to where I am. I'm like, okay, wait, where's the exit? Where's the trailers? And she looks at me. She's like, really? 3 years into this, you're still getting lost on this thing? That is hilarious. But that, I love the fact that when you go on the U.S. Navy ship and then you come onto our set and you're in the P-ways, you literally can't tell the difference. I mean, they've done just a spectacular job. The art direction and everyone, the set designers, are fantastic. And as Hank said, the Secretary of the Navy came on the show and made a cameo last year, which was unbelievable within itself. But he feels like we're doing a very good job of representing the Navy well. And when he's on the set, he said he can barely tell a difference. So it's just it's amazing. It's a great honor to be a part of something that is just done so well, and that you know, we have a lot of eyes looking at it in every detail with the U.S. Navy, and we represent them well, and we love it.
To piggyback on that, because the scope is epic, you know, it's always about, okay, how much higher we can take this up the ante, you know, bigger and better. But I remember there's also an episode, I think the first season, where the scope is smaller and it was just only a few people in the room, like a small drama kind of setting. So how do you decide, like, okay, let's just bring the mood down for another relaxed, just like one location kind of drama for this one episode?
Your episode.
Yeah.
Well, yes, last year I wrote and directed what we call a bottle show, which is all takes place on the ship, one. And it's kind of like a one-act play.
Exactly, that's the one.
Those episodes are great because, you know, end up saving a lot of money because you don't have all the location work and all the costs that go with that, and they end up being very character-driven, which is fun for the writers, the actors.
It
also creates a really nice rhythm in the season where you go big and then you stop and slow down, go a little bit small, and we always try to create that balance on the show between suspense, intrigue, you know, high octane action, then more character. I mean, some episodes are mixed and some episodes are you know, you slow down and you deal with the emotional toll of what things that they're going through. And other episodes, they're going so fast with the action, they don't even have time to stop and digest how they feel about any of it. So, you know, we have a number of episodes this year that are a little bit more on the ship and highly, you know, a little bit more claustrophobic, a little bit more about what's out there, some sea battles where you're more on the ship and seeing it from their perspective, where it's just ships chasing on the radar and you don't know what they're going to do, and you're really in the point of view of our characters, and so those are fun. And so it's good to have those sort of internal shows where the characters really get to, you know, get down on their skin.
So the new season will have that. Okay.
Yeah.